Hello students, myself Nirav Rajan. Today I am going to represent you the conversion of decimal number system to octal number system. In session of number system, we have seen the basic fundamentals of octal number system. In octal number system, there are 8 characters starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Only these 8 characters are considered as a octal numbers. In octal number system, there are 2 parts, integer parts and fractional part, similar to the decimal number system. Dear students, today's in these sessions, we are going to learn about integer part of octal number system. Today's, I am going to teach you the step-by-step procedure for conversion of decimal number system to octal number system. Dear students, listen carefully. Here, I am going to teach you how to convert decimal numbers into octal numbers. Here, I take an example 5397 of decimal number. Now, we proceed for its octal conversion. For its octal conversions, we need divisional method. And for our reference, we use calculator. Here, 5397 is divided by 8. Why 8? Because 8 is a base or radix of octal number. So when we divide 5397 to 8, then we get answer 674.625. Here 674 is become quotients and the remaining term is become 0.625. Now we multiply this 0.625 with 8 for getting our remainder, right? So at here we get 5 as a remainder. So we write 5 in the place of remainder. Now in next step, 674 is divided by 8, then we will get answer 84.25. So when we write 84 as a quotient, then we will get remaining term 0.25. Now this 0.25 is multiplied with 8, then we'll get remainder 2. Right? Now next step, 84 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 10.5. Here 10 becomes quotients and remaining term 0.5. 0.5 is multiplied with 8, then we'll get the answer 4. 4 becomes remainder, so we place this 4 at remainder place. Now another next step, that is again 10 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 1.25. Amongst this answer, 1 becomes the quotients and remaining term 0.25 is multiplied with 8 for its remainder. So at here we get remainder 2, so we place these two at the place of remainder. Now 1 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 0.125. Here 0 become the quotients and remaining term 0.125 will multiply with 8, then we'll get final remainder as a 1. So now we assign MSB and LSB to the remainder. Here this arrow is indicate the position of remainder. In the answer 5397 of decimal number, which converted into octal number like this 1 2 4 2 5. Now we take another example for your more learning. Dear students, let's we take another example for decimal to octal conversions. Let's we take 617 of decimal number for its octal conversions. And for that we use divisional method, and for our reference we use calculator. At here 617 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 77.125. Amongst this answer, 77 becomes quotients and remaining term will become 0.125. This 0.125 is multiplied with 8, then we'll get the answer 1 as a remainder. So we place this 1 as a place of remainder. Now, again, in next step, 77 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 9.625. Amongst this answer, 9 becomes quotients and remaining term 0.625 will multiply with 8, then we'll get 5 as a remainder. Now, 9 is divided by 8, then we'll get the answer 1.125. Amongst these, 1 is become quotients and remaining term 0.125 will multiply with 8, then we'll get answer 1 as a remainder. Now, in last step, 1 is divided by 8, then we'll get answer 0.125. Here, 0 become the last quotients, right? And the remaining term 0.125 will multiply with 8, then we'll get final remainder, that is 1. Now, we assign LSB and MSB to the remainder. Here, arrow indicates the position of remainder for answer. Here, 617 of decimal number will convert into octal number of 1151. Now, students, I am representing more examples for your practice. Dear students, this way we can convert decimal number system to octal number system. Now, this is all about the today's sessions. So students, be curious and keep learning. Thank you.